Thank God for every one of you who is watching us and listening to us through whatever device you may be using, either on Facebook or WhatsApp. We welcome you to this opportunity to be able to bring to you the Word of God. We thank God for giving us the opportunity that amidst all that is happening around us, we have an opportunity to be able to bring to you the Word of the Lord. And we bless God because despite what is going on, He is still in control. He is still reigning. He is still together with us as He promises in His word. When He spoke to the apostles, He told them, "Lo, I'm together with you to the cross of the age." And because this is a dispensation before the cross of the age, we are assured that the Lord is together with us. His grace is sufficient. He is going to walk together with us across this time and give us victory. We are assured that as we believe God and we wait on Him, He is going to guide us through and we are going to emerge victorious because He says that He knows the plans and the thoughts that He has towards us. In Jeremiah 29, He is declaring, "For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, and I know the plans that I have towards you, and those plans are for good, not for harm." And those plans are to give us hope and to lead us to the expected end. We bless the Lord, therefore, for the opportunity amidst the crisis to be able to bring the voice of the Lord and to be able to encourage every one of us to continue to believe God and to wait upon Him even in this time. I want to bring to you the word of the Lord on the title, Waiting Upon the Lord. Waiting Upon the Lord. Before we begin to read the word of God, I want us to pray together so that we can begin. Let us believe God and pray. Everlasting Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we want to thank you for this evening. We want to thank you for this opportunity. We want to thank you for every of our listener or viewer, whatever they are. We want to thank you for this season that you have made. We acknowledge your sovereignty. We acknowledge your power. We acknowledge that in it all, you are the Lord and you reign in the heavens above, on the earth and beneath the earth. There is none to be compared with you. Thank you for the opportunity to be able to share your word, even amidst what is happening. We pray that you will speak to our hearts and minister to our souls as we surrender ourselves to you. Have your way and illuminate our hearts through your word and give us ability to believe and to wait and to continue the hope in you, because in you is the fullness of victory, is the fullness of joy, is the fullness of peace, even in such a period of time. We thank you and we bless you. For this we pray in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Wherever you are and listening to us today, we want to draw our attention to the book of Psalms, chapter number 40. The Bible talks about waiting upon the Lord. This is a psalm written by David, and I want to read through from verse number 1, and I will continue to speak as we move on. Bible says, "I waited patiently for the Lord, and He turned to me, and He heard my cry. He lifted me up out of the slimy pit, out of the mud and mire. He set me on my feet on a rock, and gave me a firm place to stand. He put a new song in my mouth, a hymn of praise to our God. Many will hear and fear, and put their trust in the Lord. Blessed is the man who makes the Lord his trust, who does not look to the proud, to those who turn aside to false gods." As we look at what the psalmist is saying from verse number 1, he says, "I waited patiently to the Lord." And when you look at how the wording have been put together there, "I waited patiently," it would have been maybe, "I waited for the Lord," or I was patient before the Lord. But he says, "I waited patiently," to mean that it was for a long spell of time that he was waiting upon the Lord. It was not for a short duration. The time in which he was waiting upon the Lord appears to me to be a long period of time. And sometimes
we may have to wait for a longer period than we even imagined. Even in the times that we are in, we might find ourselves having to wait for a longer period than it is. Many times, people want to hear that the wait may not be long. People want to hear that it is going to end soon. But sometimes, it may not be the case. I remember the Lord speaking through Jeremiah, and he is telling the children of Israel, you are in this captivity, and it is not coming to an end very soon. You will have to wait until 70 years are accomplished. And when he talks about 70 years, he is talking about an accomplished timing of the Lord. 70 is a complete number, such as 7, 14, 21. So 70 is a complete number. He is saying until the fullness of time is realized, you will have to remain in this captivity. Therefore, encourage your daughters to give their hands in marriage. Encourage your sons to marry. Build yourselves homes. Plant for yourselves vineyard, because you will be in this situation for quite some time until the fullness of the time is realized. And here the psalmist is also saying, I waited for the Lord patiently, because it was for a long period of time that he had to wait upon the Lord. It was for a long period of time that he had to continually put his faith in the Lord. The situation may not be coming to an end very soon, but we have a reason to wait patiently for the Lord, because there is the ordained timing of the Lord, and God is the one who reigns supreme, and he is the one who is in control right from the beginning to the very end of the current crisis. There is no government in the world that can be able to predict with a certainty when exactly the crisis is going to come an end to an end. Many have tried, but they have ended up failing. But we needed to trust upon the Lord, because it is him who is the Alpha and Omega. He is the beginning and the end. He holds this situation, and he alone will be able to bring it to an end. As we wait upon the Lord, let us know that the purposes of the Lord, that which he desired to accomplish, even in such times, because some people may be wondering, where is God maybe in the midst of all this crisis? Where is God? Why is he silent? Or what is God doing in the current situation? But I want to encourage you that the Lord is together with us, and he has his purposes that he wants to fulfill even through crisis. The Bible says that it is him who wounds, and it is him who heals. It is him who bruises. It is him who bites. It is him who gives life. It is him who kills. He is supreme. He reigns. He has the ultimate power. He controls everything that happens on this earth and in our very life. So even in this crisis, the Lord is together with us. And what we can do is just but wait upon the Lord. We wait upon him patiently, like the psalmist is saying. And he says that when he waited patiently for the Lord, that the Lord turned to me and he heard my cry, and he lifted me out of the slimy pit, out of the mud and mire. So the place at which David was waiting upon the Lord was not a comfortable place. It was in a pit. A pit is a place that is raw, a place where you are looked down upon, a place of misery, a place of disappointment, a place of being brought down. So he was waiting upon the Lord from a pit, but he waited upon the Lord. And the Bible says that the Lord pulled him out of the slimy pit, meaning it was a slimy one. It was slippery. It was full of mire and mud. So in a place where it is full of slimy mud, it is a place where whatever you want to hold does not have ground. You try getting a grip, you slip back. You get a grip, you slip back. You try to grip this, it slips back. And we are in such a time where even that which we thought was studying, even the nations of the world that we thought were studying, even what we thought that was being seen as firm is giving way. Whenever you try to rush, you may not find any help from the sources of this world, either from families, either from governments, either from the jobs, places of work, businesses are being shaken at this time. But the Bible still reminds us that the name of the Lord is a strong tower where the righteous can run unto and they will be saved. When we run unto the name of the Lord, we will be saved. When we run unto the name of the Lord, we will find our safety. So David is waiting upon the Lord on this slimy pit where you try to hold anything and it gives way. But he waited upon the Lord. It is the Lord himself who pulled him out of the mire. It is the Lord himself who pulled him out of that slimy pit. And the Bible says that when he pulled him out of the slimy pit, he set him on a rock. He put him on a firm ground. When the Lord will get us from this mire, the Lord will get us from this slimy pit, when the Lord will get us from this situation of helplessness, he will put us on a firm rock, the rock of ages. He will put us on a place that is firm, a place that is secured. And we will be able to bear testimony, as the psalmist is saying, that he has set me on a rock and he has given me a firm place to stand. He has put in me a new song. So the Lord will put in us a new song. And we will be able to declare his wonderful works. We will be able to declare his greatness. We will be able to declare the great things that the Lord is doing in our lives. So as the psalmist says that the Lord pulled him out of the mire, I want to promise you, my viewer, I want to promise you, my listener, that the Lord will pull us out of this situation. And he will set us on a rock. And he will put a new song. Today, the song we are singing is of the current crisis, of the way things are giving way, of the things, of the way that businesses are not moving, of the way that maybe the economy is collapsing, of the way that the government is unable to respond. But the Lord will put a new song of a testimony of a God who walks together with his people in crisis and leads them to security. The Lord who hides his people in his own pavilion and he sets them on a path of safety, even beside or in times of crisis. Like the psalmist writes in the Psalms of 23, he says that even if I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for the Lord is together with me, and his rod and his staff will comfort me. The Lord will walk together with us. He will comfort us by his staff and his rod. He will shepherd us. He is going to lead us through. He is going to guide us through this crisis. And we shall appear on the other side with a new testimony of what the Lord is doing in our lives. I want you to encourage your heart to patiently wait upon the Lord. I know it is not easy to wait. I know sometimes we wonder, when is it coming to an end? Sometimes we have so many questions, but we can choose to relax and to bank on the Lord. We can put our faith in God. We can bank on the faithfulness of our God. We can trust him to walk together with us. And when you trust the Lord, you do not have reason to be shaky. You do not have reason to be fearful. You do not have reason to feel like everything is giving way. When you trust the Lord, you can relax on his promises. You can bank on his faithfulness. You can know that the one I have put my faith in is well able. Just like Paul writes, him I have committed to him my life. He is well able to keep me and to keep that which I have committed to him against even the worst of the days. The Lord is faithful to walk together with us in these times, in trying seasons, in times that we feel like we have no other place to look to. We can lift our eyes unto the Lord. Like the psalmist says, I will lift my eyes unto heaven. From where does my help come from? My help comes from God, he who made the heavens and the earth, and he will not let my leg to slide. So as we bank on the Lord, he is going to give us victory. The greatest thing we can do is to learn to wait upon the Lord. We can wait upon the Lord in our homes, In our families, we can wait upon the Lord. As individuals, we can wait upon the Lord. There is no better time that we can have even quiet time in the presence of the Lord as we wait upon Him than times like these. These are indeed beautiful times for us to patiently wait upon the Lord, to seek to hear what the Lord is saying to us in such crisis, to seek to understand what is His purposes. What does it want us? What does He want us to attain out of this? What does He want to achieve out of us in this crisis? Because He has made us to be alive in such a time. There is something that He wants to do with our lives, even in these times. And ours is to wait upon Him, seek Him, listen to Him, and hear Him, so that we can be able to connect with His purpose for this time. And after this season, there will be another season, a season of great victory, a season of singing a new song, a season of new revival, a season of God visiting His children. But it can only happen for those who pass the test. Whenever there is an exam, it is those who sit through the exam and are able to do it well and excel that at the end of the exam, they have a reason to celebrate. They have a reason to rejoice. They have a reason to benefit out of the hard work. But us as Christians, as we go through this very trying and testing time, once we emerge, those who will be patient, those who will be able to bear the test, those who will be able to allow this season to refine us, to make us better, to draw us closer to God, will emerge on the other side, more refined, more empowered, more encouraged, more powerful, to be able to declare of the wonderful works of the Lord. When the psalmist finally stands on a rock, when he stands on a firm place, he has a new song. He has a new testimony. He has a new message. And every one of us, as we appear on the other side, after trusting and waiting upon the Lord, until this crowd passes through and until the purposes of the Lord are accomplished, then we will emerge on the other side with a new song, a new message of hope, a new message that we are going to be sending forth to the nation as we declare that the Lord is together with His people. I want to encourage you not to lose your heart, not to be discouraged, not to feel hopeless, but to trust in the Lord, but to wait upon the Lord, but to focus your mind, your heart unto the Lord. We are living in a time when so many people are discouraged. Many people are following through. They wait every time there appears that icon on the TV saying in a short while the minister will be coming, and people are like, what is he coming to say? What are the news? What are the numbers now? And many of us may be caught up in panic. Many of us may be caught up in fear. Many of us may be caught up in the mire and forget that we have a God who is concerned, who cares, and we can put our faith in Him. So despite the increase of the numbers day by day, despite the news that may be coming day by day, we can put our faith in God and we can believe God to walk together with us. And for sure, we will be able to encounter victory. So I want to encourage you, you who is listening to me, you who is viewing me, wherever you are, let us learn to wait upon the Lord. And when we wait upon the Lord, it's not like we are waiting upon a man. A man may fail, but God will never fail. God will never fail. When we wait on Him, He will surely come, like He did for the psalmist. He will do for you, He will do for me. Let us put our hearts, therefore, to God and wait and bank on Him. And it is not possible to wait on somebody you do not have a relationship with. You need to have a relationship with Him so that you can wait upon Him. And it therefore begins at the point of you acknowledging that you need God in your life, that without God, you have no other way of help. The Bible says that He is the ever-present help in the hour of need. Therefore, I want to encourage you, you who is looking at me, who is listening to me, and you do not know the Lord as the Lord and Savior of your soul, that this is a time to consider deeply in your heart and accept Him, the Lord Jesus, as the Lord and Savior of your soul. and you begin a new life of waiting upon him whom you have a relationship with. If you are there and you're listening to me and you feel encouraged today that you want to commit your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, you want to make him the Lord over your life, I want to give you this opportunity to do so by saying these words after me, even as you believe God. Say, Lord Jesus, I come to you. I acknowledge I am a sinner and in need of your mercy and in need of your forgiveness. I accept you, Lord Jesus, into my life to be my Lord and my Savior. Forgive me of my sins and take away my iniquities. Write my name in the book of life. From today, I will be your child. I will follow your word. I will obey your commands. This day, I get saved and I believe. Thank you. If you've made that simple prayer together with me, I believe from today you are a child of God. I want to encourage you to continue to read the word of God, to devote your time to prayer, and to continually fellowship together with those you may be able to reach, even over the different platforms that we have, that you can be able to share your testimony, that today you have come to the knowledge of the Lord. Share with somebody over the phone, share with somebody over the Instagram, share with him over WhatsApp, and whatever other mechanism you may be having, declare that the Lord is good to you. And I believe as we walk together, God will be together with us. Shall we pray even as we come to the end of this sermon this day? Our Father and our God, thank you for speaking into our hearts and reminding us to wait upon you. You who is the ever-present help in the hour of need. We choose to anchor our faith in you. We choose to put our faith and hope in you. We choose to lay our hearts in you. We choose, Jehovah God, to relax in your promises, O God, knowing that you are in control of you and what you are going through today. I pray for every of my listeners today that, God, they may find the peace in you and waiting upon you. Encourage every one of them who is discouraged. Heal them that are sick. Set them free that are bound. Lord God Almighty, I pray that your hand will be upon your people and you will hide them in your pavilion, that this trouble and calamity will not be able to destroy their lives. Thank you, Jehovah God, because by your hand, we are assured of victory. We are sure that we will stand on the other end. Having come out of this miry pit, we will have a new song to declare the wonderful works of our God. We thank you because you'll be together with us and you will give us victory. We bless you and we honor you and we give you glory. You are the Lord, God Almighty, and beside you there is none. Receive all the honor, glory, and praise. For this we do pray, trusting and believing in Jesus' mighty name. Somebody say, amen. From Faith Harvest Utawala, one of the branches of Faith Harvest Ministries, or Faith Harvest Churches International, we have our main branch in Roysambu. We have another branch in Juja, Muirigo, and here in Utawala. We bless the name of the Lord for you joining us today and hearing the word of God from us. We believe that God will bless you and he will do you good even as you continue to wait upon him. Shalom. God bless you. God do you good. Thank you.